Good morning students. In previous class I already explained that is economic activity and types of economic activities. In types of economic activities already I have explained there are the three kinds of economic activities, that is business, profession and employment. Today in this class we are going to learning differences between business, profession and employment. This topic you can expect in the examination, that is 1 marks or else 2 marks. Before going to this topic or before going to explaining this topic, I would like to tell you that one moral story or one motivational story. This story I will tell you in Kannada only. You can just listen. It is a fantastic story. Okay. Ondu manele chikka kutumba, appa, amma, magalu ಮತ್ತು ಅಜ್ಜಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಜನ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಪ್ಪ MNC ಕಂಪನೀಲಿ ವರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ನಿಮಗೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ MNC ಕಂಪನೀಲಿ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯೀಸ್ಗೆ ಸ್ಯಾಟರ್ಡೇ ಮತ್ತು ಸಂಡೇ ಅಂದರೆ ವೀಕೆಂಡು ರಜೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅವತ್ತು ಕೂಡ ತಂದೆಯವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಯಾಟರ್ಡೇ ಆಗಿತ್ತು, ರಜೆ ಇತ್ತು. ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಎದ್ದು ಪೇಪರ್ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದರು. ಮಗಳು ತುಂಬ ಹಠ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ಲು. ಏಂತಕ್ಕೆ ಹಠ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದಾಳೆ ಅಂತ ಆ ಕಡೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಮೊಸರನ್ನ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ತಿನ್ನೋಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ತುಂಬ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಮ್ಮ. ಆದರೆ ಮಗಳು ತಿನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ ರೆಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಆಗ ಅಮ್ಮ ಬೈತಾ ಇದ್ಲು, ನೋಡಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಗಳು ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಠ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಳೆ ಮೊಸರನ್ನ ತಿನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ನೀವೊಂಚೂರು ಹೇಳಿ, ನೀವು ತುಂಬ ಫ್ರೀಡಮ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀರಾ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಗಳಿಗೆ, ಒಂಚೂರು ಹೇಳಿ ಅಂತ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪ್ಪ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಮಗಳೇ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ತಿನ್ನು ಅಂತ ಒಂಚೂರು ಪ್ರೀತಿಯಿಂದ ಮಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಗ ಮಗಳು, ಅಪ್ಪ ನಾನು ತಿಂತೀನಿ, ತಿಂದರೆ ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ನಾನೇನೋ ಒಂದು ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಹಾಗೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಆ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು SSLC ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ. ಅದೇ ಥರ ಈ ಮಗುನೂ ಕೂಡ, ನಾನು ಮೊಸರನ್ನ ತಿಂತೀನಪ್ಪ, ನೀವೇನಾದರೂ ನನಗೆ ಕೊಡಿಸ್ಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಕೊಡಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ಅಪ್ಪ ಆಯಿತು ಆಯಿತು ಮಗಳೇ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಮಗು ಮೊಸರನ್ನ ಬೇಗ ತಿಂದ್ಬಿಡತ್ತೆ, ಖಾಲಿ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಡತ್ತೆ. ಅಮ್ಮನಿಗೆ ಖುಷಿಯಾಗೋಯ್ತು, ಓ ಮಗಳು ತುಂಬ ಅಪ್ಪ ಹೇಳಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ತಿಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಲು ಅಂತ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂತಿದ್ರು, ಮಗಳು ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದು ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅಪ್ಪನಿಗೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಮಗು ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಮುದ್ದು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಯಾಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಪ್ರೀತಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಡೌಟ್ ಬಂತು. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಮೊಸರನ್ನು ತಿಂತೀನಿ, ತಿಂದಾದಮೇಲೆ ನಾನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಆ ಮಗು ಅಪ್ಪನ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದು ಅಪ್ಪ ನೀನು ನಾನು ಮೊಸರನ್ನ ತಿಂದರೆ ನೀನೇನು ಕೊಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ, ಓ ಹಾಂ ಹೌದು ಮಗಳೇ, ಏನು ಹೇಳಮ್ಮ ಏನು ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅಪ್ಪ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಗಳು ಹೇಳಿದ್ಲು, ಅಪ್ಪ ನಾನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ನೀವು ಕೊಡಿಸ್ಲೇಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಇಮ್ಮಿಡಿಯೇಟಾಗಿ ಅವತ್ತು ರಾತ್ರಿ ಅಪ್ಪ ಸತ್ಯ ಹರಿಶ್ಚಂದ್ರ ಕತೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಸರಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದನ್ನು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾತು ತಪ್ಪಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಗಳು ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸಿದ್ಲು, ಅಪ್ಪ ನೀನು ಸತ್ಯ ಹರಿಶ್ಚಂದ್ರ ಕತೆ ಹೇಳಿದ್ಯಾ, ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನೀನು ನನಗೆ ಈ ಮಾತನ್ನು ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೇಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದನ್ನು ಕೊಡಿಸ್ಲೇಬೇಕು. ಅಪ್ಪ ಇದೇನು ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಪ್ಪ, ತುಂಬ ಚೀಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ನೀನೇನು ಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಡಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ ಮಗಳು ಅಪ್ಪನಿಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲು. ಅಪ್ಪನಿಗೆ ಆಶ್ಚರ್ಯ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು, ಅಂಥದ್ದೇನು ಕೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ ಮಗಳು ಅಂತ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಗಳು ಇಮ್ಮಿಡಿಯೇಟಾಗಿ, ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಪ್ಪ ನನಗೆ ನಾಳೆ ಸಂಡೇ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನೇನೋ ಒಂದು ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳೋದು. ಮುಂದೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ನೌ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್. When you writing that differences or comparison, when you doing that comparison, you have to write basic or basis. Understood? BASIS or BASIC. Basic or business, profession, employment. Understood? With the help of basic or basis, you can easily do the comparison of business and profession and employment. Let us see that one by one point, or let us understand, or let us, I'll explain that one by one point in detail. First one, mode of establishment. ಇಯರ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಕೆನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಕೆನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಹೌ ಐ ಕೆನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮೈ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಾಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಇಫ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಶಾಪ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಅ ಓನರ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಪ್ರೈಟರ್ ಪ್ರೊಪ್ರೈಟರ್ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ he has to take or he or she has to take that to start up the company or a business and other legal formalities if necessary other legal formalities is something but before starting any kinds of organization or a business whether it is a small business or a medium business or large scale operations you have to take a license understood or you have to go with a legal formalities understood it is called in a way that you can start your business and next we have that profession mode of establishment in profession membership of a professional body earn certificate of practice that mean how you can start your profession suppose you want to start your profession called CA you want to become a chartered accountant before that you have to register with a ICAI Indian Cost Accountant of India ICAI you have to register your name that after completing the course they will going to issue the certificate understood you have already practiced after passing that after success of practice they will going to issue the certificate with this you can start your profession or example teacher if you want to become a teacher a lecturer you have to take a master degree with recognized universities plus mascard understood for passing of master degree it is a confirmation for mascard if it is satisfied you can start your teaching profession this is just example how you can start your profession and next coming to that employment appointment letter and service agreement that mean after completing that interview the company will going to issue the appointment letter in appointment letter date of issuing appointment letter or place and rules and regulation and what is the salary package you are going to getting in a company and what are the rules and regulation you have to follow in an company it is called appointment letter and service agreement in a way that you can start your employment in an company it is called mode of establishment in business profession and employment coming to that second basic is nature of work that mean nature of work is nothing but what is the work of business and what is the work of profession and what is the work of employment let us see that the work of business is provision of goods and services to the public that mean the business has to satisfy the needs and wants of a people or a customer what it has to do that mean the business has to produce the goods and services that goods and services they have to offer to the customer it is called nature of work coming to that profession that mean rendering of personalized export service that mean in profession what is the work of profession they are going to render is nothing but giving understood they are going to giving that services suppose doctor will going to give a service to his patients that mean teacher will going to give his work to the students lawyer will going to give his work or his service to the student or institution this is the best examples for the rendering of export services in employment what is the work of employment after getting a appointment letter he or she has to work or he or she has to give his work to the company understood along with they have to follow the some rules and regulation mentioned in the appointment letter this is called nature of work in business profession employment
ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್? ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ನೋ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ನೆಸೆಸರಿ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡಿಸೈಡೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನಲ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟಡ್? ಈವನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಪ್ರಿನರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಓನರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಟ್ ಅ ಕೋಟಾ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಲ್ ಗೇಟ್ಸ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಟಾಪರ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಟಾಪರ್, ಬಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟಾಪರ್ ಆಫ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆರ್ ಮೈ ಎಂಪ್ಲಾಯೀಸ್. ಕೆನ್ ಯು ಸೀ ದಟ್? ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್. ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್, ದೇ ಕೆನ್ ಸಕ್ಸೀಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಎ ಮೋಟಿವೇಶನಲ್ ಕೋಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಬೈ ಬಿಲ್ ಗೇಟ್ಸ್. ಸೀ ದಟ್? Understood? Once again, I'll repeat. That means I am not a university topper, but all the university toppers are my employees. Understood? That means in business, no minimum qualification is required. Coming to that, in profession, compulsory qualification is required. Suppose if you want to give your service as a teacher, the teacher has to take that, or they have to pursue the master degree plus bachelor of education. Understood? If the teacher, they want to teach to the class 11th or class 12th, that means first PUCs or second PUC, the teacher or lecturer, they want to complete that master degree plus bachelor of education degree. If it is the two certificates or two degrees, they can easily teach to the class 11 and class 12th. And coming to that, in employment, qualification is required, compulsory is required according to the job specification. Suppose in Kumar organization, they have the vacancy for the accountant. The Kumar will going to deciding for accountant job is only for offering a commerce students. Understood? Suppose in Kumar company, they have the vacancy for the technical job. They require the technical background, a technical education like ITI or BSc or BCA. Understood? These are the example. That means qualification is compulsory in employment. Profession also it's compulsory. And in business, no need of qualification to start the business. Coming to that next basis, reward or return. That means, what is the return you will get in business? What is the return you will get in profession? What is the return you will get in employment? That means, reward or return in business, earning of profit. After selling of your goods, you will earn money. That means, you will earn extra money. That means, how we can calculate the profit? That means, cost, investment minus cost. Investment, I have invested 10 rupees minus cost. After producing a product, I have fixed the cost called 12 rupees. What is the margin? 10 minus 12 is equal to 2 rupees. Extra 2 rupees I earned. This is called profit. Next, in profession, I'll get professional fees. Understood? Suppose the doctor will offering the services. The doctor offering his services to the patients. Understood? After treating or after giving the services, doctor will collecting a fees, not salary. Understood? The profession, they'll going to collect the fee. And next, coming to that employment. In employment, salary or wages. Return called salary or wages. And next, capital investment. That mean, in business, it is a capital is compulsory required as per the size and nature of business. That means the capital investment, it depends upon the small business requires less amount, medium business requires medium amount, and large scale operation required more amount or more investment capital. Understood? And coming to that, in profession, it require limited capital needed for establishment. It not required much amount of capital or much investment. In the profession, it require only the limited capital needed for establishment. And coming to that, capital in employment, no capital is required because of we are giving our service to in a company. No need of capital in employment. This is all regarding to that capital investment. Coming to the risk, what is the risk factor in business? What is the risk factor in profession? And what is the risk factor in employment? In business,
The profit are uncertain, irregular, risk is present. That means very simple. The risk is present. That means in business, we cannot expect what will happen in a future. In yesterday class, I already explained that is element of risk and uncertainty of return. That means we cannot expect what will happen in a future. That is the reason in business, the risk is present. And coming to that information, some risk, understood? Yes, some risk is something, but fees is generally regular uncertain. That means it is not much compared to that business. In business, they have that more risk, but in profession, they have that less risk or some risk. Coming to that, in employment, no risk. That means if the company will get a profit or what, no problem, because the employee will getting a salary for every month. In employment, no risk. Next one, transfer of interest. Transfer of interest is nothing but it is possible to transfer that a work to in business, in profession, in employment. Let us see that in business, transfer possible with some formalities. In business, they can transfer their interest, they can transfer their work to the some other person. Suppose they have the two person, Kumar is the owner and Jagadish is a employee. Suppose Kumar wanted to deposit the money in a bank. Understood? If it is not possible deposited by the Kumar, Kumar can transfer his work to deposit the money in a bank. He can transfer this work to the Jagadish. It is possible in business. Understood? That is transfer possible with some formalities. And next, in profession, not possible. How it not possible? Suppose I'm as a doctor, I want to do that operation. It is possible to transfer to someone, you can do that operation? No, it is not possible. Even if the teacher, suppose I'm teaching in the classroom, I have got the call, some call, urgent call, I have to go for a home. It is possible to transfer my work to someone else in profession? No, it is not possible. Understood? In profession, it is not possible. Coming to that, in employment, transfer of interest is not possible. That means the company what they have given the work, that has to perform by only employee. Understood? It is called transfer of interest is not possible in the employment. And last but not the least is code of conduct. That means rules and regulation. And coming to that here, in business, no code of conduct is prescribed. In specific authority is not prescribed any rules and regulation compulsory the business as follow. Understood? There is no code of conduct in business. And in profession, professional code of conduct is to be followed. That means, suppose if you want to pursue that as a lawyer, you have to take a register certificate, or you have to register with a Bar Council of India. What that Bar Council of India framed the rules and regulation or call it as a code of conduct, the lawyers has to follow. Understood? Even the doctors, they have to register with a some authority, Medical Council of India. Understood? Medical Council of India. They have to register and they have to follow their norms or their code of conduct. In professional code of conduct is to be followed. If you want to become a chartered accountant, you have to follow the rules and regulation framed by ICAI or some other authority. Understood? In that mean code of conduct, in professional code of conduct is to be followed in profession. And coming to that, in employment, norms of behavior laid down by the employer are to be followed. That mean what that organization has prescribed that rules and regulation, that has to followed by employee in an organization. They have to follow compulsory. In appointment letter also, they are going to mentioning, that is the reason they have to compulsory follow the code of conduct. That means totally they have that 8 point. You can write it any 2 points in an examination, you will get 2 marks. Understood? Any 2 points. It is not specifically you have to write this point only. It is your convenience, which is it's better for you. You can write it that point in a examination. In the next class, I'll going to explain you that is classification of business activities. Thank you.